Hey guys, Ryan here from Indie Wrestling School, and today we're talking about why it's important as a professional wrestler to stick to the time you're allotted. Coming up. Hey guys, thanks for checking out this video. If you're new here, please consider subscribing below. We put out new videos every single week. I know a lot of times the fans like to stick up for the wrestlers and they kind of put the promoter's heads on the stake and start yelling at them and yelling for blood, and the wrestlers demand more money and all this kind of stuff. And I understand why the fans would think that. And I've covered this before, but in the end, it just means the fans are paying more. All the costs go up in the end. And one of the things I've seen a lot is that fans telling the promoters, well, they should have gotten more time, or they should be able to take as long as they want. And I'll tell you why that's not good. Typically for a promoter, you have a set amount of time you're allowed to be in the venue. So you have your setup and you have your breakdown time, and then you have the show time in between that. And believe it or not, your setup and your breakdown typically is longer than the show itself. So you're paying all that overhead to rent this building, rent this space, for times that you're not even making any money, because that's how long it takes to get the building ready, to get the ring set up, to get the music and the audio and everything put together. So all of that is already overhead that you're paying as a promoter. Now, if somebody goes long, and then the next match goes long, and everybody goes long, at the end of the day, you now have eaten into your cleanup time, and you may need to tack on another hour, 2 hours, 3 hours to break down all the stuff, and now you're paying for that extra 2 or 3 hours, which could be hundreds, if not thousands of dollars extra that you didn't plan for. Who's paying for that? Do you go to the wrestler and tell them to pay for it? No, it's never gonna work. You're never gonna see that money. You're gonna pay for it. So a lot of times wrestlers look at it as, you know, if I'm the first match on the show and I go 5 minutes long, that means everybody else just needs to go 1 minute less. And that's a fair compromise. But no, you're in that opening spot for a reason, because you're supposed to be professional. You're supposed to be able to stick to your times. You're supposed to be able to set the pace for the entire show. And the promoter, if you're anything like me, has meticulously planned for every minute. Every minute, every segment is accounted for, so you meet your window of time. For me, the ideal window of time is 2 hours and 15 minutes for a wrestling show. All in, all together, intermission, the whole thing. 2 hours and 15 minutes. I find that anything longer than that, and people are sitting on their hands or they're getting up and leaving during the main event. So your job as a wrestler is to stick to your time. And whether that's the opening match, whether that's the match before intermission, whether that's the final match of the night, you need to stick to your match, because it doesn't just involve you and what you're doing. There's a lot of people involved in this. Now, let's say you run long at the end of the night. Now, does the promoter not only need to pay the building, is there staff and everybody that needs to be paid an extra hour or two, or are there hourly people there? I know for a fact that I've had wrestlers on the show that needed to be involved in the main event. Somebody went long and they missed their train. We had to find somebody to drive them back into Manhattan at like midnight. So when you think about, like, it's only this match and it's only an extra 5 minutes, that's incredibly short-sighted. It affects everybody on the show, not just the fans, not just the staff, not just the other wrestlers, not just the promoter. The entire show is affected. What do you guys think? Is it okay to run long during your matches? Do you kind of just get to make up and do whatever you want? Or is there set rules, and should you be following what the promoter decided ahead of time? Or is it somewhere in the middle? Let me know in the comments below. That's all for this week. If you like this video, beat the shit out of the like button, and we'll see you next week right here on Indie Wrestling School.